5 mistakes that people make when choosing a doctor. Relying on rating websites. Patient reviews are just a measure of a doctor's soft skills. Reviews can tell you how polite, how rude the doctor is, but does nothing to tell you how competent the doctor is in treating a particular condition. Good soft skills are an important part of any physician's overall skills, but what is equally important is that a patient understands the difference between a restaurant review and a doctor review. Relying too much on friends and family recommendations. Referrals from friends and family are an informal way of review on rating a doctor, and you can be assured that there is not deliberate bias in this recommendation. But in spite of their best intentions, family and friends have little information about a doctor's true expertise in treating a particular disease. Not understanding what board certification means. Board certification is not a mandatory requirement for any doctor and is only a measure of minimum competency. Too many people get a false impression that board certification is some kind of measure for a high level of competency. Board certification does show a doctor's commitment towards lifelong learning and his commitment towards his profession, but is not a validation of whether a doctor is skilled in treating a certain condition or not. Not knowing your doctor's specialty. Medical mumbo-jumbo can be confusing for a layperson, but some basic knowledge can help you get the right doctor fast and might save you a lot of money, which you would have spent bouncing around from physician to physician. Not to forget the benefits of a quick diagnosis. Most people would look for a cardiologist by default for any heart disease, but there are more than 500 diseases that fall under cardiology specialty and would require doctors who specialize in treating that particular disease or a subset of diseases. Just Googling for a cardiologist would be a waste of effort. Not understanding that doctor is a part of a bigger team. Good doctors don't exist in a vacuum, and they need a good team to support their treatment efforts. Take time to understand which hospitals a doctor is affiliated with, and what kind of staff, equipment, and service level does the hospital provide. For more information about expert doctors and hospitals, please visit www.expertdocs.com.